Hey, what's going on, guys? The Horror Man back on an unseasonal slashback Saturday. This week's slashback challenge theme was halfway to holiday slashers. I challenged everyone to watch and review a slasher film set on or around Christmas. Merry Christmas in July to all, and to all a good night. My pick for this week's theme. To All a Good Night is a 1980 slasher film, and believe it or not, this was a first-time watch for me. It's a bit like Sweet 16, which I reviewed during the Slashback Challenge last year. That was also a first-time watch. To All a Good Night and Sweet 16 were both 80 slasher films that somehow got past me. I had always wanted to see them, but for some reason, it took me all this time to do so. In fact, I never even owned a copy of To All a Good Night until a month ago, when I bought this DVD. When I finally watched Sweet 16 last year, it instantly became one of my favorite 80s slasher films, and I was hoping to have the same type of experience with this one. Well, To All a Good Night is a fitting title, because this one had me on the brink of falling asleep. I mean, it wasn't terrible, and I can't say I dislike it. It's still an 80s slasher film set around Christmas time, so I enjoy it for what it is. The thing is, though, it didn't really have to be a Christmas slasher. There was really no reason for that. The killer dresses up as a psycho Santa, and the movie takes place over Christmas break. There are Christmas lights, and a Christmas tree, and Christmas wreaths. But without all of that stuff, it really could have taken place at any time of the year. The point I'm trying to make is the fact that it's Christmas time really has no bearing on the story at all. Regardless, it's still obviously a Christmas slasher. To All a Good Night was directed by the late great David Hess, and it stars Jennifer Runyon in her first starring role. She played Gwendolyn in Charles in Charge, she played in Ghostbusters, she played in Carnosaur, and she plays in another Psycho Santa slasher, Silent Night, Bloody Night 2, Revival. This one is about a group of students at an all-girls school who decide to throw a party over Christmas break while the superintendent is out of town. They invite some guys to the party, and of course the typical drinking and obligatory sex scenes take place. Meanwhile, someone is dressed up as Santa Claus, killing them off one by one. It's interesting, because after doing a little research, it seems that this is the first feature-length Psycho Santa slasher film. The only thing I could think of that predates it is the An All Through the House segment from Tales from the Crypt, but that's just a segment in a horror anthology film. And although Christmas Evil was released in 1980 as well, it was released later in the year. I really like the look of the Psycho Santa in this film. It's not just a Santa beard and Santa outfit, but it's a full Santa mask. There are some pretty decent kills, like some slashings, an axe to the face, an arrow through the back of the head. The acting is terrible. It just is. Jennifer Runyon's character spends the whole movie talking about how scared she is. And as I sort of implied earlier, it's very slow for maybe the first hour. And then things pick up. Now, I had originally planned on saying more, but as always, I don't want to spoil it. So all I'll say is, To All a Good Night was blatantly ripped off by another very popular 80s slasher film. Blatantly. I mean, it almost could have been a remake. Seriously. I've seen some actual remakes that are more different from the original film than that very popular 80s slasher film is from this one. But that's all I'll say about that. Ultimately, in the end, I did enjoy To All a Good Night. Like I said, after all, it is an 80s slasher film. The opening death scene is worth mentioning too. It's pretty funny. They clearly used a dummy in place of the victim's body. Which is a nice transition into the new slashback challenge theme. Repeating the theme with which I followed up Christmas in July slashers last year, let's play with some killer toys. I mean, Christmas and toys go together, don't you think? This week's slashback challenge theme is terrifying toy slashers. I challenge everyone to watch and review a slasher film featuring deadly dolls, psycho puppets, maniacal mannequins, or terrifying toys. Now, That doesn't mean they necessarily have to be the killers. But of course, they can be. It just has to be a slasher film featuring toys, dolls, puppets, mannequins, or anything like that. So get watching and get reviewing Terrifying Toy Slashers. And as always, be sure to upload your video on Slashback Saturday. I will also be back on Saturday with a new review and reveal of a new theme in the Horrorman's Slashback Challenge. Thanks for watching, guys. Be kind. Subscribe. Oh, give me a shout.